Shut up and sit down.
Hey friends, I'm Simon.
I'm not.
Oh, hey not. And if you like our videos, please remember to like, comment, subscribe, and of course, hit that bell thing. That would be very kind of you indeed. And tonight, Not and I are surprising each other with trailers that we've not yet seen and filming our typically stupid reactions.
So what do we have coming up next?
Well, next up, you know, Nicolas Cage does a lot of movies.
Oh, he does a lot.
A whole lot. Yeah, a whole lot. Some of those movies are amazing. Some are also movies that Nicolas Cage does. And a movie came on my radar this week that I just had to check out. I've not seen this trailer either. The premise is that Nicolas Cage plays a truffle forager whose favorite pig has been stolen. Literally, that was the only thing I needed to read about this before I was like, we have to watch this trailer.
What?
Exactly.
What?
So we're going to go ahead, check out this movie that comes out in July in just a couple of weeks. And if you want to know what, then stick around until the end. But for now,
let's go, I guess.
I also guess let's go.
Here, piggy.
Oh! I hope the pig is called the Declaration of Independence.
What? I love his pajamas as well. Was it a demon?
I'm looking for a truffle pig.
Aren't we all?
Someone stole her.
I don't understand.
Tell me you are.
You made the right choice. Being out there in the woods. There's nothing here for you anymore. There's really nothing here for most of us. Buy yourself a new pig.
You can't just take a man's pig.
What are you thinking?
I remember every meal I ever cooked. I remember every person I ever served. You live your life for them, and they don't even see you. You don't even see yourself. We don't get a lot of things to really care about. Who has my pig?
Wow. So we've just seen the trailer for Pig and I still have no idea what was going on.
No.
It kind of started off like Hansel and Gretel style with him in a forest and some kind of monster stealing his pig from his hut. Then he was in, I don't know, New York or somewhere?
Yeah.
With modern people? But he still was very grubby.
Yeah.
I don't know. What did you think of Pig?
It was very confusing. It seemed like such a silly movie, but he plays it so earnestly. And I feel like that has to be part of the joke for him to play. Because I kept getting really taken in by his performance. And then he'd just be like, my pig got stolen. And I'd be like, oh, it just took me out of it. Because I'm like, pig.
And yeah.
But his performance is incredible. I do wonder if maybe he is like some kind of incredible, well, obviously, like he's some kind of incredible chef who I guess I think it was New York. He looked like New York.
Yeah. Yeah.
Who was
some
like,
kind of big
had
city.
Some restaurant in New York And then in my head, his hut looks like it's in the middle of nowhere in a faraway place, but it's actually like Central Park. Just in a bit of like the muddy bit in the back of Central Park. And that's where him and his pig hang out to go get truffles. Hmm. But what does he do with the truffles if he hasn't, like...
Does he just live on truffles? Yeah, because it didn't look like he was going to eat the pig, did it? That would have been a faux pas.
But it didn't look... Like, if he has no connection with, like, civilization for a million years, then why is he collect... Like, he doesn't have anything to do with the truffle. Like, he doesn't take them to market or something.
I got to say, I was looking at it as something's not real in this equation. Like, either the forest isn't real. Like, maybe he's just a homeless guy living on the sidewalk. Ooh. Maybe the pig is a metaphor and didn't exist all along. Maybe the modern people are the animals. Like, I'm sure in my head I was just looking for that twist. Like, where is the thing where they're actually going to say, well, you didn't realize, but blah, blah, blah. And so I'm going to go,
So the pig is, like, his... zest for life and love of cooking.
Yeah, or his white whale, his Moby Dick. I don't know. Moby Pig. But yeah, I don't know what to make of this. It's such a weird looking movie. But like you said, he plays it so earnestly. And he put as much emotion into his lost pig as he did in the movie Mandy, where his wife was burned alive in front of him. And like in Mandy, you can look at his character and say, well, of course he's broken. You just saw his wife turned into a shish kebab in front of him. But in this, you're like, dude, it's a pig. I mean, it was a really nice pig. And
yeah, go get another
one. And like, even that guy just said, go get another pig.
Yeah, it seemed harsh, but I'm like, yeah, go get another pig. There's tons of them.
Yeah. But I must say, I loved him in Willy's Wonderland, which was such a weird movie. I still don't know why he was drinking those sodas and gasping every 5 minutes. Like, that was a weird movie. Mandy, I really enjoyed, and that was a super weird movie. This at least looks better than Jiu-Jitsu, that kick-puncher movie that we didn't watch. So yeah, I don't know. I think I'm just fascinated enough to give Pig a try. I'm feeling like, though, this is probably the last trailer we're going to get until the movie actually releases. We're going to know nothing more about this movie, which maybe that's a good thing. Maybe there are enough twists and turns that we'll be like, well, I'm glad the trailer didn't ruin it for us.
So quite often with these movies, we pretend we're going to watch it and we've got no intention of watching it at all. We're just saying that to be nice. I genuinely want to watch this.
Yeah, me too. Only because I'm so puzzled as to what. I just cannot get it.
So the bits that aren't real is it's not a pig. It is the Declaration of Independence. And he is one of the security guards trying to protect the pig. But in his mind, he's living in the forest. And his pig is stolen by Nicolas Cage.
Oh, wow. That's...
And he has to solve elaborate puzzles to get it back.
Yeah, and one of those puzzles is he has to steal 100 cars in 24 hours and get them on a container ship. Yeah. But I feel that the real national treasure through all of this is, of course, Nicolas Cage himself. I mean, the swear words show was awesome. He just, to me, he definitely doesn't knock it out of the park every time, but he just is such a crazy workhorse and throws himself into everything he does. I cannot look away. It's just mesmerizing.
So the real pig is the gifts that Nicolas Cage has given us along the way.
Yeah, maybe we're the pigs and we're always just searching for Nicolas Cage in a forest, snuffling after our truffles. Well, we don't think you guys are pigs, but we do hope that you're finding your Nicolas Cage, whatever that may be for you personally. But I guess, you know, we are going to go ahead and watch Pig in a few weeks, though, which I'm somewhat surprised because I mostly picked this out of sarcasm. But
yeah.
There we go.
Nicolas Cage, curse you.
Yeah, damn you, Cage.
Draws right back in again.
Yes.
The real Nicolas Cage is the friends we made along the way.
Yes. Well, friends, we are glad that we met you along the way. But that's all we have time for tonight. So we will see you tomorrow on the next Dork Trailer Ambush.
Peace out, Nicolas Cage.
Bye.
Shut up and sit down.